This is Chris Kell with your hip internal external rotation test corrective exercise circuit. For our first exercise in this circuit, we're going to start out with a little bit of self-massage, right? For this purpose, I have one of two choices here. I've got either a tennis ball, right, which is a little bit softer, a little bit more focus roll for somebody that is really tight. We're going to start here. We also have a white lacrosse ball. This is a little harder. This is going to get into those areas a little bit more. You know, and as you kind of dissipate some of these areas, you work on the self-massage, you get a little looser. We want to move from the lighter ball to the heavier ball, and then eventually to something smaller like a golf ball. All right, so I'm going to put this down here. I just want to stand on it. Press into this area. What I'm looking for are just kind of knots or lesions that have formed along the muscle here. I'm rolling from the bottom of the foot all the way up to the top of the foot. You're going to find that it's, you know, feels like a knot or like a something balled up. And this is just lesions that have formed along what we call the plantar fascia here, the foot. When I find this area, what I'm going to do is just press down, wiggle my toes, kind of oscillate into it so we start to dissipate that area. And just hold here for anywhere from 1 to 3 minutes. Now from here, I'm going to move to my calf. All right, with that, once again, I'm going to start here at my Achilles tendon, and I'm going to roll all the way up to the base of my knee. And what I'm looking for are just sore spots, tight spots, anything that feels abnormal. I can turn my foot to the outside here to really hit the lateral area. All right, and I can turn my foot to the inside to hit the medial area or the inner thigh or the inner calf here. But just look around for it. You might find something down here by the heel. You might find something way up by the kneecap. Wherever you do, just get into that area, cross your foot over it, and again, just oscillate. Move this foot up and down. Just try to get in there like a jackhammer until this area starts to depress. All right, again, spend 1 to 3 minutes on this on each side, and move to our last area, which is our hip, right, or what we call the butt cheek. So with this, what I'm going to do is just put this more in my lateral butt cheek. So like this area here, I want to sit on this thing here. Move this thing out of the way so you can kind of see me a little bit better here. But what I want to do is just sit on this thing, and I want to cross the leg to the side that I'm rolling. All right, I'm just rolling around until I find a spot that is electric. I mean, this is going to feel, you know, really abnormal. It's going to feel like almost you feel tingling. I just want to find that area, let this thing sink in, try to relax as best I can over it. You'll notice I'm crossing my leg here. This is kind of ratcheting up the tension. If you find that this is too intense, you can come down and simply straighten it out. The progression from there would be to cross. But again, just spend, you know, 1 to 3 minutes on that spot or until it dissipates, and then move to the next spot. Now from here, we're moving into what's called our pigeon pose. So this, we've kind of released the knots in the muscle. Now we're going to stretch it out. What I want you to do is cross one leg in front here. I'm going to get the back leg behind me, twist in like this. What I can do is just, again, oscillate over this muscle. I don't necessarily want you to hold a static stretch. I want you to hold in this position, but I want you to twist into external rotation and try to force a little bit of range of motion from the muscle. So we're trying to gain range as we do this. I'm just twisting in and out, kind of twist the end range, contract your muscles, that's telling our nervous system to release it. Contract it, hold for about 5 to 10 seconds, relax, come back for a second, twist a little bit more, once again, contract, relax. So we kind of hit the barrier of where we can move. We contract, we tell the nervous system to let go of that area, and then we kind of move into the new range of motion by twisting this way. All right, regardless, I want you to do that for anywhere from 90 to 120 seconds, and then we're going to finish up with our standing drill. All right, now our standing drill is what we call single leg stance. With that, you're simply going to stand in one leg. I want you to contract the butt cheek of the down leg, so this side. Get up as tall as possible. I want you to think about just standing as tall as you can, really feeling it here and just balancing. All right, one of the things that we often see, a compensation we see in this exercise would be leaning forward or, you know, wobbling to one side or whatever it may be. So in the beginning, you can stand next to a wall, use the wall for support if necessary, kind of just touch it if you need it, but just stay in this position, really tighten that butt cheek, and do this as many times as you can. I like to hold for 10 to 20 seconds, and as you become better, we can progress to up to a 60-second hold, but that is your corrective exercise for hip internal external rotation.